I don't even think Jesse knows. I told you I was getting ready to start it. For why? Oh God.
Hello everybody, I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports. It's hard to imagine this not being a fun game to watch. It's the Bengals going up against the Falcons. For the call, let's send you out to the broadcast booth where we'll join our commentators,
no, I'm the Falcon.
Brandon Guyton, sir. And Charles Davis.
What? When was I ever going to be the Bengals?
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air.
It wasn't
a few
actually.
Moments ago, it was Desmond Trufant of the Falcons making their way out of the tunnel to the delight of this sold-out crowd as his guys get set to do battle with Andy Dalton and the Cincinnati Bengals. Hello again, everyone. Brandon Gunn along with Charles Davis. And Charles, we take a look at this Falcons team as they interplay. They come in off a good win on the road, and now they hit the home opener at 1-0.
And that's because we ran out of time.
My goodness, over 50 points in the win
and
last
I stopped
weekend.
Passing the ball.
When you do that, you're not going to lose very many games, maybe not any games.
Meanwhile, for the Bengals here, they come off a good win in the opener on the road.
Wait, when did you have a good what? 4 points. What? Well, no. For our game, we didn't.
Favors, but if they can win here and get to 2-0 on the road, they could be well set up for the rest of the year.
And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. They'll be led out by the man taking number 3 overall back in 2008. It's their now veteran quarterback, Matt Ryan.
And at times it's hard for me to believe I'm saying veteran Matt Ryan. Still remember him coming out of Boston College, full of enthusiasm, mastered their
Why did I hear the Dragon Ball Z
teleport
feature?
What a player.
They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. He finds an opening past the 40.
Jesus.
Devontae Freeman, they're not good again.
First play. First play.
Devontae Freeman.
75 yard touchdown run.
Now on the year. And the Falcons have taken the early lead. Heck of a start to his season.
Yeah.
He had two touchdowns.
It only took one play.
Week,
yo, Daniel, you remember
right
the touchdown day at
early,
least that you fought Jose Pierce?
In,
it was the
you
last
know, you
day of the car.
Good about things. You get into that zone, and those touchdowns come in bunches. He
so
may be off to that kind of a start.
It's like he was shot
yeah.
out of a cannon. I would imagine success this early, great momentum going forward for the rest of the year.
This
he
week,
keeps
yeah.
this up, they'll soon be chanting MVP.
All right, so when did you play the Saints?
Here come
that
the
was
Bengals
impressive.
Now to take over.
So I
they'll be
don't
led
really
out
doubt.
By the former Texas Christian University Horned Frog.
Oh, what, week
Andy
two?
Dalton.
And there's no substitute for experience in this league.
Oh, I didn't even know you played your
to
game earlier.
A whole lot of confidence. Andy Dalton is sharp with where to go with the football now. I think he sees reads before they actually even happen.
Ding
he can
dong.
Sense them now, and he is one of the better quarterbacks in the NFL.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
They go play action here on first down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Well, this
oh,
is taken in.
How did
it's
you
complete.
Know?
Jesus. An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
Yeah, that's AJ Green.
So let's go ahead and add to the difficulties
that should have definitely
of guys
been picked
trying
off.
To cover receivers. They got to deal with speed, shiftiness, all that stuff. But how about when they have height and length and deep downfield, you throw the ball up in the air, that's how they uncover at the end of a route by being able to go up over the top and make a big catch.
He finds Ross, right side, it's complete.
So,
and he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 7 yards.
Were you at home
the
against
catch.
The Saints, Dan?
Boy, the mm-hmm. evolution of the game and how these guys in place like
wow,
that can get out of the pocket.
Game?
appearances.
It really does, and we're talking about an era in the game.
Yeah, you were at home.
Quarterbacks are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, when you talk about collectively, it's unbelievable. So their ability to move is practiced now. It's not necessarily, oh, he just took off and you guys figure it out. When he takes off, everyone knows where to go now. They know how to run routes, change things, make themselves presentable for the quarterback. That's a lot of time that they put in on it. It's not just your static 1-2-3. This is where the ball goes anymore.
Boom!
And no escaping this time as he'll go down.
Wait,
they got him for a sack.
Grady
Jarrett continuing to fight downfield. The big tackle gets him for a loss of 11.
Are you watching mine or are you
they
playing?
They were able to win last week despite him being sacked four times. They might need to tighten the reins a little bit.
What's his face?
This one may not end in another victory.
Because every time something happens, he reacts. And I thought he was playing his own game.
They can't let the accumulation
oh, no, not Desmond Trufant.
The harassment in the pocket get to their quarterback. Got to stop that. Give him clean lanes to throw the football in order to have a better chance to win again this
hurt.
Week.
Well, he seems to be all right over there on the sideline. Talking to Matty Ice.
So on fourth down, Marvin Lewis sends on the field goal unit. And quite a bit of pizza in this box. Yeah. It's a 53-yard attempt.
53 yards.
And this one looks
they
good.
Said 53.
It is good. Right down the pipe. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. A little bit of a lower trajectory there.
Well,
the
what it is it's
it
7 yards back
because he had to drive it out
plus
because of the length
10
of the
yards
kick.
For where
able
the
to do
field
that,
goal
got it above the defense.
So you add 17 yards on the wherever the ball is at.
Let's just field it at the goal line.
Oh!
And he breaks it all the way out to the 38-yard line. Great return. So out come the Falcons now. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description because
probably.
When we talk about
I mean, I did one
run,
last season.
About a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air.
Oh, geez.
Pressure gets him that time. Down he goes. Oh, free safety blitz. That can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass. And when he comes at the quarterback, he'd better get home and make the play. Otherwise, a big play could result for the offense.
Dude.
He's going to go down again.
Jesus.
Geno Atkins. In there to get him. And this pass rush strong now. That sacks on back-to-back plays.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
Third and long. It's Ryan. He's going to fire one.
Boom! Gabriel held on to it.
And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield.
Thank you, Taylor Gabriel.
Give him 35 yards there on the third down conversion. Ryan on the handoff. It's Freeman.
Oh, okay.
And this one's going to go the wrong way. Losing yardage back at the 42. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Noah.
A tale of two extremes. First carry, he went for
like, what is Noah doing?
His second goes backward.
And how many times have we seen that happen? Because you get that big carry, and you come back, and you're all fired up, and sometimes you force a run a little bit, right? Trying to bring up that big carry again. And instead, it works opposite.
And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. And here are the Falcons.
Maddie D versus.
It's real easy to express how much you love
Maddie D versus.
Because when you watch him perform
this week,
you see a little bit of everything. You see speed, you see strength, you see the power with the run after catch. But what you don't see is the work he puts in during the week. And you also don't see this, a number one receiver, one of the best in the league. That doesn't act like a diva.
Yeah.
On third down, Ryan. Finding Gabriel complete.
They're able to convert on third down.
Taylor Gabriel saving the third down again.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. Mm. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock the defense off balance, that'll drive the team towards a victory.
Forced out to his left. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
I mean, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Now Ryan on second down.
Mohamed Sanu, touchdown!
This time for Mohamed Sanu, touchdown. Mohamed Sanu, his first touchdown of the new season, and the Falcons will extend their lead.
He was able to move around and found some vision to throw the football.
If I didn't throw it when I did, it was a
sack. Zip on that throw.
It doesn't hurt to have an arm like that. Results in the touchdown here. Great play offensively.
Because it's Geno Atkins that keeps getting to
it. 14-3 ball game.
And he's arguably, he's arguably like one of the best defensive tackles.
Now here's Bryant to kick it away.
Yep.
Got to field it in the end zone. And no run back here. This
I've been
will be a
twice.
Back, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
Two straight
Cincinnati
fucking plays.
Now ready to take the
field. Two straight plays.
And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They
on that,
really
and then I threw that deep ball to what's his name? Taylor Gabriel on the first
game.
Third down. It was like third and 34.
Distances that we almost start to take them for
now.
Granted. And we can't
Giovanni
do
Bernard.
That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure. Because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see.
Because they tackle better than I do.
Cincinnati, 69 yards. Well, welcome to the party. First carry of the game. How about that?
And just think, as far as he's concerned, he's just getting warmed up.
And that'll get him halfway there as he takes it from the 6 to the 3 yard line. In backfield out of this starting group, you have to look out for Giovanni Bernard.
And you have to make sure you're ready to hit the spin button with this guy. Awfully exciting in the open field.
They come out here in the eye. Here's a run with Mixon, and this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Without the videos,
his path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Yeah, but I'm trying to concentrate as well.
Dalton on third and goal. And he will score. Touchdown, Cincinnati. Andy Dalton, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Bengals able to get this back within a touchdown. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week 2 now.
How about the pace he's already established, right?
Yes.
Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season. But don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can't.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. And then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him. Start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. Found a little room there as he's up.
That's
to
actually harder than
it
thinks.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. And the Bengals starting defensive unit now.
Mm-hmm. Geno Atkins battled some injuries in 2015 and was challenged to get back to his form, and he did exactly that in 2016. Back to the Pro Bowl. Size, strength, agility, and also a competitive streak that rivals anyone's in the league.
Yeah, because we took the Excel clock off because there was a lot of issues with
Freeman again.
I only have 14.
Looking
Jesus.
For an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
A minute. And on third down, three, a nickel two, formation here one. Defensively.
Well, so many times
no.
We look at a short
the most I've ever scored in this league is 70.
Establish things, but the defensive guys.
No, it's against Grant.
They don't always have to absorb the body
blows.
Sometimes
them.
They dish them out themselves.
A good pick up there, 20 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse.
Still oh shit, Dylan.
Throws a nice pass for first down.
Throws a quick hitter on the slant. That's complete. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. They get 10 more there,
well,
and I believe
enough.
That'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball.
So.
But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
I might if he could take it.
They'll throw on first down with Ryan.
Ah! Face mask!
What the fuck?
And down he goes.
That was a
taking
touchdown.
It inside the 10 to the 7. It'll be first and goal when we come back. 14-10 the score. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
Jerusalem.
The NFL on EA Sports is presented
well,
by
no.
Snickers.
You have to. You're the
you,
reason
you're
we want you to create an.
Satisfies.
Wait, are you Jesse?
And they've
or
got it here
Andrew?
With a first down.
But no, you're not Andrew. You're Jesse. You're good.
And now the offense
you're
in
it already.
In the
right?
Red zone.
Yeah. You're good. Yeah, you're fine. We want Andrew to create a new one because his don't work
they'll
on anything.
Here with and they'll get him down here at about the 5 yard line. It'll be a three
and we
yard pick
that
up,
and
it
he needs it for W2 because we can't tag him in it.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier, was bidding for a second. On second down, Ryan escaping the pressure right. And this
that's
is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Devontae
Freeman. Receiving touchdown,
touchdown
a roughing touchdown.
Fourth of the year. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. So he scrambled right, but was able to look back toward the middle of the end zone to find the target.
As you know, in this game, sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules because we all know most
oh
guys
God,
throwing
really?
The football are taught never throw back into the middle of the field on a scramble. He did it and got away with it for a touchdown.
Instinct sometimes, right? They just take over.
Instinct and vision. Sometimes you just see people who are open. You're able to get it to
them.
And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback.
You are the
Bengals getting set to go. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Kind of works.
The drive starts with a handoff to Bernard. And he'll wind up with about six up past the 30 to the 31.
Let's talk a little football 101 here because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Trust me, we know what you're doing on that day.
It's second down. Dalton looking.
Boom! Boom!
Falcons get there.
Sack!
The Falcons get
I ate him
sack.
Alive.
There he goes. Adrian Claiborne.
He ran right into me. I was like,
for a loss of seven. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the ball, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys that they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
12 yards that time and a Cincinnati first down.
We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes you break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking in the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play, and that'll make this a second and 13. Dalton with a give here to Mixon. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. And it looks like a pickup of six. That leaves him with 7 yards to go on third down.
Only took him 3 hours to
come back. It's
really
nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game plan.
3 hour pool?
They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe.
I have no idea if Adam accepted my.
They can still run the football and get enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against?
I don't know how I feel about that. Alex doesn't have internet, and Hamza hasn't responded.
Is one of the big guys up front moved.
And in a 4-3 front, you've got the two defensive tackles right near the football. I know there's a lot of movement around there, but they're always taught to have one eye on the football. Apparently, that didn't
happen.
Here's Bernard. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
But with the kind of half he's had, I think we can forgive him that run, right? Not every run's going to be a big play, is it?
No, and also the blocking just wasn't there. No room to run.
Yeah, defensively, they got to find a way to build on that because he's eating them alive in the first half.
And he's brought down. Dalton to his big target, Eifert, for the Cincinnati first.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Dalton throwing on second down. Caught Eifert over the middle. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage. First down.
Running here with Bernard. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Well, that play was doomed right from the start.
They just about ran into every defender on that one, didn't he? It felt like everyone got a piece of that tackle.
Mixon. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. 2 yards gets him back to where they started, but now third and 10.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by guys.
Complete. The Bengals passing game finding a rhythm. They've got another first.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it, because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
And it's
flag.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down.
Yep.
So let's see what this is about.
Holding offense.
Russell Bodine, 61.
Except down in this one, they needed that score, but they'll have to hold at least for the time being.
You're exactly right. Points that they had to have. As you said, they have to regroup now and see if they can get them another way.
From the gun, Dalton looks to throw.
That's complete, Bernard. And they'll bring him down.
Did we hurt
the
Bernard?
18-yard line.
Don't know.
But just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
Yeah. Ronnie Bernard is still on the fucking field. So who got hurt on that last one? And a flag. False start.
Flag. And I believe a Bengal got going a little early there.
Yeah.
False start. Offense.
Yeah, that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five.
I think it's 74.
Offense has been out there a while. This is their 14th play in this series. Second down, Dalton. Over the middle, that's caught by
Bobby
Ross.
Wagner.
And that's a big collision. He's knocked backward as they will mark him down at the 13-yard line.
Well, as this game continues to evolve in the NFL, you know how much coaches love run after catch, but you know what they love even more? Completion.
Yeah, just holding on to the ball.
Catch it, cover it, tuck it away. Whatever you get after that is almost gravy. That's how a lot of these receivers are being taught now.
It'll be a gain of eight, but it also lead to a fourth down.
Patriot.
We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Larry Ridley will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Bullock will put this one through. And the drive will wind up yielding three. So give them three there.
No.
A good drive gets them inside the five, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit,
because I was going to do that more towards the tournament.
Bend, but don't break approach. But it kept the offense out of the end zone.
After the field goal, now it's Bullock to kick it away.
Yeah. Because I told LaDon, I was like, yeah, he's not going to debut until the tournament.
Pretty good here at the 30-yard line.
Give him time to work on his play style.
Yes.
Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it can be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
We'll see how it is.
A good pickup there, 22. He's been the forgotten man in this first half. Not a guy you want to forget. Not only his first catch, first time they've targeted him.
That doesn't make any sense, does it?
Best years of my life, and this is the thanks I'm
doing. When he does come alive, when they do look his way, not only is it a big catch, it's a first down.
Give him 12 yards on that one, it earns him a fresh shot of downs. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to it, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Is it Jesse?
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure.
Like, it was only when Jesse was watching the game,
a great
it only said it
quarterback, but
so,
felt the pressure, threw it incomplete.
Oh, okay.
And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
It feels like they're getting caught in between here, because an incompletion's on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock, because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half.
No, it's just Deshaun. He's like one of the few guys in the Macho Club that didn't have Macho as a last name.
He's unable to haul it in, so it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field, and that brings up fourth.
It's on the
I know we're just in the second quarter, and there's a ways
website
to go in this game.
Under Pure,
that's a second
I haven't
drive. Wondering if that's a little bit of an alarm bell for them when they start calling plays on the offensive side of the ball.
His eyes already looking upfield on that last one before he brought it in.
It's good to be the kicker for the top offense in the NFL, and Matt Bryant was that in 2016. Led the league in scoring with 158 points. But boy, does Atlanta find him valuable. So dependable and clutch.
And he's been valuable in this league for a while. Hard to believe he's been around since 2002. All right, let's focus now on Giovanni Bernard. Now he's having himself a little bit of a banner game. His team right now, though, losing.
Oh, I don't know.
Needs a little bit of help.
I mean, I would assume.
A basketball game where you have the big score.
Well, that was when everybody was making a big deal about weight classes.
England have all of his points. Let's hold down everyone else, and that's the way you win the game.
Yeah,
and right now, he needs everyone else to start scoring.
One of their receivers.
Yeah, and he's hoping to keep it close so maybe they can keep it on the ground.
John Ross.
Start to go through the air as much. To throw on second down, Dalton. And his throw is incomplete. His big tight end, Tyler Eifert, the intended receiver. And it's third and short.
That was Andy Dalton's first incomplete pass.
No matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
Green's got it over the middle.
You fucking broke.
And eventually taken down, but how about that athletic spin move we saw? Gives him the first down yardage. Play fake here on first down. He's gonna let this
pick that ball
deep.
Off. Pick it off. There you go, Jalen Collins.
Picked
there
off
you
by
go.
Jalen Collins.
Boom.
He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here.
They
but
said
an
he had the pick six
that's
last week.
Because that's the word we use when we intercept a pass. Oski tells your team to rally around and block.
Hey, man,
for
blame
you.
Them.
So
they're the ones
really
talking
well
about
it. Last week, because they made that way to the end zone. This week, he got Vioski, maybe not a touchdown, but boy, he's playing really well.
Played Daniel last week.
And we won't see a
they were talking about his, my dude's pick six.
As they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one.
Yep.
On first down, Ryan. Flush to his right.
Hey!
Caught on the right side by Jones. 23 yards on the play.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he's able to get on the run. And
well, it's not Cincinnati, so it's got to be either you or
Cleveland.
And it isn't you because you played
the
Saints.
Last year, tops in the NFL with that powerful offense.
And you played the Saints
already.
Looking
for more.
So.
Here as they've got it first and 10.
Boom! Julio! Touchdown! Boom!
Touchdown, Atlanta! Julio Jones! In the final seconds of the first half, and the Falcons will extend their lead.
I can't not take this.
That's a lead that excites a team as they head into the half. Good way to finish things off.
Yeah, able to extend that lead, and you always say it, that can totally change the complexion of half number two.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook, but even before that, let's see if they decide to kind of sweep kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff, because you don't want to give up
who
a big play right before the half ends.
Good point.
So that's the Super Bowl. What the hell happened to episode one? Or, oh no, you know what? I stopped it. Because we were switching characters. Did you throw an interception already?
So we are at halftime here in Atlanta with the Falcons out in front. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we halftime report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Falcons are up right now and are looking to keep up the pressure moving forward. The Bengals just want to come out after the half and claw their way back into the game.
The Titans.
All right.
Now you folks don't know what you're missing. You're missing Larry
Ridley.
Who's
week three?
Ready to get back, though, to this week two matchup.
Oh,
let's get to it.
Oh, God.
Both teams appear ready.
At least he doesn't have to play me.
And we resume action here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
and I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. But this is a I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Tough running there. That's a hard earned.
Fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
They'll run again with Bernard. He works his way forward for a couple up past the 30.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Throwing Dalton on the screen.
Buffaloes. He's like Buffaloes. The water Buffaloes.
The 30. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one. Well, you can see what they wanted to do. They wanted to set up the screen there, but it got blown up.
It's hard to run that play if you're not getting a lot of pressure at the quarterback because the space doesn't open up.
So did Adam actually join that back one in?
And slow it down and stop it before they could get a first down.
It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. And now let's discuss Julio Jones.
So many
previous
exactly.
Series, definitely a focal Jesus. Point. Three catches, the touchdown grab. As a DB, your former DB, is there a number of catches on a draft?
No, I mean, I'm talking about cool boy and
I'm not sure there's a number,
they throw
but there's
so
a
many
feel. And what he did on the last
Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him.
Devontae Freeman.
Touchdown.
Yeah, right now it says I have no views.
Devontae Freeman.
78 yard touchdown.
And fifth on the year.
Yeah, it says I have no view.
And that run massively increased his production in this game, and now he's over 100 yards.
One play, 78 yards. Well,
because his yards per carry went up significantly, right? Big time jaunt all the way to the end zone.
Now here's Bryant to kick it away.
I mean, it would help develop your guys, but that's completely
up to
you.
In the end zone.
I do it every
and
week.
He'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And out now, here come the Bengals. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think this
friend.
Is why you lost 75-6.
Go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so
well,
else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
We'll start on the ground here with Bernard, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
Playing.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action, hit them over the top.
So second and nine, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here. Again, here's Bernard. And he'll get
I mean, it doesn't even
to
seem to matter that he has Tom Brady because he throws
there,
seven or six or seven interceptions.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take him in short, steady bursts.
Third down, a shot here for Dalton.
No, it'll start like three or four, maybe five.
So a big call there that brings up fourth.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. Fielded just inside the 20. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And possession will switch hands,
supposed
first
to be,
and 10.
Ice.
Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read the keys and make the proper play?
Another mistake here defensively as a flag is down on the tackle, and that's going to tack on 15 more.
Daniel, did you see that?
So that flag will cost him 15.
Crying. Cool boy, shut up.
Doesn't matter anymore.
Devontae Freeman's head snapped back. Yeah. I don't know how to zoom in. Okay, there we go. Slow motion. Yeah. Just snapped his head back real quick. He's like, ah, goodbye.
It's going to be 15 yards.
If you aren't hurt, you might be now.
Throwing now, Ryan on first down. And Jones has it over the middle.
I believe in you.
But not before they're inside the 25. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
I really don't think that Julio Jones could be happier right now. Plenty of catch opportunities in this game. He's converted them, and his team's winning.
And Matt Ryan's happy, too, to have Julio Jones on the other side of these.
Yeah, you know, a lot of times we talk about breaking teams down, and oftentimes it's through a running game. These two, they can break a team down through the air.
And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
I swear, I don't think he balances his offense. The red zone here.
On second down, Freeman. Okay. And he's heating up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
And he's got it.
Austin Hooper.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Austin Hooper, his first touchdown of the new season.
And this is why you throw so many interceptions. Because you don't, you don't run the ball, so there's no variety. So then they know you're going to pass the ball.
When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving them up.
They run coverage to stop the pass.
Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the
end zone. And then it probably doesn't help. You probably throw it into a slew of 18 defenders to your one dude.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said, you're going over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far,
yeah, but you're not Bill Belichick.
Exactly,
you're
they
Matt
need
Schmidt.
Any spark at this point. They'll run it now out of the gun.
Your shit's good.
7 yards on the carry. Make it third and four coming up.
You got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
They'll run it now.
Damn.
Out of the
oh!
And he maybe
makes nice play
it
by King Kaha.
Scrimmage. That's it. No gain on the play there. A nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. The Bengals bring out their punter now.
as he'll come on to kick this one away. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. This is taken at about the 14.
Oh, no, illegal block in the back.
Holding, receiving team.
Or holding.
A pretty good return, all things considered, but holding.
I agree with you totally. It's actually a return that they were going to be very proud of. But when you end up holding and bringing it back, now your offense has to start a little bit deeper in your own territory.
God forbid.
On first and 10, it's Ryan.
Jesus.
Hey. Taken down.
Thank you, number 67, for not doing anything.
Andrew Billings.
Love you too.
Coming up the middle, gets him there for a loss of about 9.
I think most quarterbacks would love
I'm up 45 to 13.
Extend up into the air and turn into a wall. They could put their back against it and know exactly where they are on the field so they don't end up in the end zone. Didn't do it on that play, but perilously close to the goal line.
That one good for 14 yards. And just like that, it's third down. From the gun, it's Ryan. And finding the tight end. Hoover.
And Austin Hoover. Ow,
great effort there.
Breaking his leg.
Contact, oh. And it helps him pick up the first. And he's got room.
Yes, please.
10 more there and another first down.
Yeah, still not Ryan. Thinking about putting in Foles.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. He bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
And now a 10th carry for Freeman. Finding some room at midfield. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point. Going to make that defense stand up and stop them. They go play action here on first down, eluding the pressure right.
Oh.
This is caught inside the 15.
And an injury timeout. Who's hurt now?
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. This is Freeman on first and 10.
Devontae Freeman walks in. Not even touched. I don't know. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, John Ross is out. Two offensive linemen.
Zone for a Falcon touchdown. Devontae Freeman, a 12-yard touchdown run. And the Falcons add on. And let's not
forget. Oh, shit. They're going to block this.
This is going the other way.
No, Matt Schwab.
He's going to go. They're
no,
not
Matt Schwab.
The 30. The 10. And he takes it the distance across the goal line for 2 points. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a couple yards deep, he'll go to a knee. He won't return it. And they'll take it out to the 25. The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field.
And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with him punting the football away.
Yes, he starts with the pressure brought in,
and the Falcons get there for
play action. Play action.
Second sack of the
in
day.
There to drop him for his second sack now here tonight.
Man,
that's
got
the
both
sack
sacks.
Of the game, but this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it. He's a big-time guy you have to block.
Dalton gives to Bernard. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. He'll get three, but it leaves him with a big hole here on third and very long.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Third and long. What will Dalton dial up? And he's able to get up here to the 26. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth.
One hallmark of good defenses. Understanding the game, understanding positioning,
coming out for the Xbox,
and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. We'll call that a 49-yard punt.
I guess they figured it doesn't necessarily matter when they bring it out because of the fact that it's already out on other consoles.
A return of just two, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Heading back onto the field, here's a look at Devontae Freeman now. I guess it kind of goes without saying at this point, but he's had a great game, as we like to say, a nose for the end zone, no doubt.
Continues to find
I don't know how I feel about CFC.
I'm sure he's got a nice place to live. He might want to make an offer in the end zone for a second home, because that's what it's been like throughout this contest. He knows how to get there, and boy, he looks happy when he does.
He's already bought all the property in the end zone. That's the problem. He's going to sell to himself now.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech.
They didn't remaster what?
Now a first down carry. It's Lacy. Broke through some contact, but unable to
they
reach
did
the 40.
It.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there.
Well, it shows
it
what it used to look like, and
it
shows what it looks like now.
Those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
On second down, Lacy.
That's how they're trying to sell it.
Push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with third and five.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. Here's Foles. He completes it to Jones. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the
What's
drive
that?
Moving.
No, no, Steve.
He's been the go-to Ow. Guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they scouted it or did they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
And only able to muster a couple down to about the 27.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Yeah, I'm going to renew my Game Pass. Well, with Game Pass, they're starting this thing where some of the newer games are free if you pay for the Game Pass.
Doesn't matter whether it's a zone coverage or a man coverage, the drag route can be effective when it's run well.
Supposedly State of Decay 2 is supposed to be PC.
Escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Vontaze Burfict. In from his linebacker spot, he's able to drop him for a loss of about 10. Foles.
Now like, he's forced
out left. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Shepard. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line.
Digital.
10 back as that sets him up for third down.
And that's why you do all the drills that you do from the quarterback position, because you're not going to just throw to your strength. The right-handed quarterback naturally will want to move to the right side to throw the football. But sometimes you've got to go left, and that's exactly what happened on that play. Forced to his left, still able to accurately throw it downfield for a completion.
Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is either throwing a touchdown or
I want to get that one game where you're the two smart guys that are trying to escape from the prison.
They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
No, cautious with that no one out or no way out or something like that.
So it's three more points, and that widens things out even further here in the fourth.
Hey, in this league,
if you look
you
on the coming
so
soon,
range,
it's on there.
Grab the three whenever you can.
Yeah.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Yeah.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score.
Now, the big thing they were saying in the trailer.
Get the sack, down he goes.
Who cares about Fortnite? Fortnite blows.
In there to get him
I don't
again.
Like the visuals.
The third time he sacked him here tonight. That's number four. Sack number four.
But
four
the big
week,
thing they were
so
the big thing they were
the ground a lot.
The big thing they were talking about that prison game is that if you're playing in a like if you want to play with somebody, only one of you needs a copy of the disc or copy of the game, and you can invite somebody who doesn't have the game and they should be able to play. That's what they were talking about in the trailer. But I don't know. It doesn't say anything on the game.
It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
I mean, it seems now that they're getting rid of exclusives altogether.
And this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete.
Yeah.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away.
What is it?
Fielded at the 33. It's a net of 40 there. A punt of 48 and a return of 8. And that will come the offense as they take over. Getting set to go again on offense. We get a peek at Julio Jones now. And I know that they've double teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing is working.
See, the thing is with that, the people who made Uncharted, or at least the same game mechanics, are in The Last of Us. So I don't think if Uncharted doesn't come, then Last of Us won't come.
They run it again with Lacy. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line.
Oh, no. Eddie Lacy, what are you doing?
And this is Lacy, remains down on the ground and shaken up. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside.
Aren't they the same thing?
And this will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning.
Yeah, right.
They'll run it now.
There's a big difference between
and
the two.
And he's
going to
be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this.
Might be Crackdown 4. At this rate. You don't even know what the hell you're talking about.
So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for first.
Is
on
really
any running
smart.
Play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now.
Daniel, I know what you should get.
On its heels.
And they pick up the
Metal Gear Survive.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So Eddie Lacy is injured with a foot
yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play.
I didn't even play the first two.
To a third down. Offense walks to the line.
Yeah, why are they remastering Dark Souls? There is no point to remastering Dark Souls.
Now the first carry for Brian Hill. And he'll
yeah,
be taken down.
Didn't buy the one 34. On the 360. Oh my God. Really?
The Falcons will call on Matt Bryant for the field goal try. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle.
So,
and they're well on their way now as the lead grows even larger.
And
it's
since
really
Eddie Lacy's hurt,
he's hitting these from distance, big time distance,
my
he
third string running
right
back came
down
in.
The middle,
his name
it?
Is Hill.
No
I believe he ran against you, Grant,
no
in the 73-13 game.
Of
and he came in for one play and got hurt.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
Yeah, if Grant's going to get it, don't bother getting it.
Because
I ain't going to play
it. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
going
Exactly. Take a quick look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly
Not really,
everything went
no.
for us today. Coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it because
you're
it's
not
probably just precautionary
feeling.
Because
you
they are still trying
knows?
To prove whether or not he did the whole steroids
They'll
thing.
Run it now out of the gun and to the 42-yard line here and brought down there.
Mm-hmm.
It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. It's do or die for Dalton. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete.
Wow.
Couldn't keep his
wow.
feet in. Second down. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
It's basically a medieval game. Like medieval times. But it's supposed to be
points,
realistic.
Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Falcons, it's a win here in their home opener as they move to 2-0. And they'll get to stay home again next week as the Tampa Bay Buccaneers come to town. Meanwhile, for the Bengals, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll be off to Oakland next week for a date with the Raiders. So that'll do it for us. For my partner,
what?
Charles Davis.
How many games are you
going to
mention
that
this game
on our crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. It's a win for the Falcons here as we say so long from Atlanta.
Well, I'm gonna be renewing my Game Pass like next week, so I'll be able to play Sea of Thieves anyway. So, if you want to get it, that's up to you. But I don't know if you can play any of the games that Grant gets through Game Pass. I don't know if they allow that. Because I know my buddy can play the games that I get through EA Access. Or you just ask Grant.